Hey, today is January 12th, 2024, second week of the year for our AI papers. As always, I have had ChatGPT summarize a bunch of papers that caught my eye from their titles this week on Archive. There's also some prereq knowledge listed if you want to read it yourself, and citations that are probably incorrect. A little note is we have 64 papers to get through and exactly an hour to do it in. A bit less than an hour because I had to like finish and upload the video and everything. So we'll see how this goes. Why solving multi-agent pathfinding with large language models has not succeeded yet. Do I care this much? Collision-free paths for multiple agents in a given environment. Propose a framework. Interesting. This is one I think it is, I don't think. Propose a framework where LLM is directly used to generate actions for each agent at each time step. They also incorporate a high-level conflict checker to ensure the generated solution is valid. This is an agency paper. It's an agency framework. Cool. Not my thing right now, but cool. Weak correlations as the underlying principle for linearization of gradient-based learning systems. I like that title. Interesting. Propose the underlying principle for this linearization is weak correlations between the first and higher order derivatives of the hypothesis function. Oh, with respect to the parameters. They define the concept of derivative correlations, which quantifies these weak correlations. Why would the derivative be correlated? Because, so I guess it would be more common to see functions that are, I always get concave and convex confused. It depends on what like reference point you're looking at it from. But like, it would be more common to see from the point of view of the loss function going down an x squared curve than it would be to see a square root of x curve, if that makes sense. Prove that wide neural networks indeed exhibit this weak derivative correlation structure. They introduce a novel method to characterize the asymptotic behavior of random tensors, which is crucial for their analysis. Drive a bound on the derivation of linearity during the training trajectory of a stochastic gradient descent, which is generalization of the traditional results from deterministic gradient descent. Interesting. Okay, let's download this one. The paper list at this point is just way too long. I have not done an actual paper breakdown video in so absurdly long at this point, like a month or two. And we need to get around to doing that, but like it's after projects get done. There's just so many projects and there's so much work. It might be a while, honestly, not gonna lie. We need to talk about classification evaluation metrics in NLP. Why? They compare, They compare several standard metrics. Propose the use of informedness as a better metric for comparing classification performance. I don't care. User embedding model for personalized language prompting. Challenge of modeling long histories for preference understanding and natural language. Propose a user embedding module that efficiently processes user history in free-form text by compressing and representing them as embeddings. These embeddings are then used as soft prompts to a language model to generate personalized recommendations. Cool. Good luck with that. YouTube, I guess. It's like a Google paper. Yeah, that's using it for YouTube, probably. Transformers are multi-state RNNs. I'm going to download this already, I know. Conceptualize the type of recurrent neural network called multi-state RNNs. They show that transformers can be seen as MS-RNNs with an infinite number of states, where each state corresponds to a previous token in the sequence. Oh, because they're in that way. Interesting. They also demonstrate, so that this has been discussed already, like that we know that you think of a recurrent neural net as being like looped, like you have to loop it, but you can also just like take a recurrent neural net, like the matrix or the weight matrix, and just like copy and paste it many times and make like just a long string of them. And although you are not actually recurring, like you're not actually sending the data back to the same matrix, you get the same calculation because it's the same matrix over and over again. So we've known this has been a thing. It's been talked about as like it's probably happening in any scenarios that require looped logic. But they demonstrate that pre-trained transformers can be converted into finite MS-RNNs by applying compression policies that limit the number of tokens processed at each step. Novel compression policy. I'm going to download this. Yes, transformers are multi-state RNNs. Curious to see whenever I do finish first project and get to doing some paper reviews, what that paper chosen will actually be. I don't know. what the group's papers. I mean, the group, like the, am I going to do, am I going to do interpretability stuff? Am I going to do functional interpretability stuff? Am I going to do mechanism stuff? Am I going to do the Mamba? I don't know yet. We'll see. Towards conversational diagnostic AI, optimized for diagnostic dialogue in medicine. All right, don't care. Thousands of AI authors on the future of AI. Surveyed researchers to gather their predictions on the progress and impact of artificial intelligence systems. Asked about the feasibility of various AI tasks, blah, 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 blah. Results show that most tasks are predicted to have at least a 50% chance of being feasible within the next 10 years. These tasks include coding a payment processing site from scratch, creating songs indistinguishable from those by popular musicians, and fine-tuning large language models. However, there's still uncertainty about the timeline for achieving these milestones, with a wide range of plausible dates, 10% chance of unaided machines outperforming humans in every possible task by 2027, and a 50% chance by 2047. I think I already saw a video on this paper from, what's his name? Big AI YouTuber, Dave Shapiro. Estimate is 13 years earlier than a similar survey conducted in 2022. Oh, so we've jumped 13 years in 1 year. Interesting. However, the full automation of all human occupations is not expected to reach a 10% chance until 2037, and a 50% chance as late as 2116. Guys, no one is really comprehending what the hell exponential means. Like, all these experts, I know they're smart people and everything, but, like, we all have this implicit way of thinking that is still linear, and I don't think people really quite get, like, the strength of the singularity arguments and, like, how exponentials actually work, especially when you have not just an exponential curve, but when you have a very complicated system with many, like, a very complicated PDE, right, it's a partial differential equations system with many different variables in it, where all of them, their rate of change increases when the other's rate of change increases, when you, like when you have, like, material science and AI and processor design, like things that, like, help each other improve even more, kind of thing, right? Like, no one really gets the full extent of how fast an exponential curve that, or a PDE that is itself exponential in form, but is also a function of parameters that are themselves exponentials, and then they are functions of it and it being an exponential, and, like, back and forth. I don't think anyone understands the combination exponential curve and feedback loop mechanism and how crazy that is. Theory of mind abilities of large language models in human robot interaction. An illusion to perceived behavior recognition where a robot uses an LLM to assess its own behavior from the perspective of a human observer. Goals to determine whether the LLM can accurately predict how a human would perceive the robot's behavior. I don't know if that makes sense. I don't care that much anyways. I'm not going to worry about it. The role of higher-order cognitive models in active learning. Potential of higher-order models in active learning, particularly in the context of human feedback. Propose a taxonomy of interaction involving different levels of cognition, ranging from level 1, little active learning, to level 5, pragmatic inference. Argue that that incorporating higher-order cognitive models can enhance AI-human interaction and improve the sample efficiency of active learning. Cool. The inherent goodness of well-educated intelligence. Explore the concept of intelligence in both biological and artificial systems. Argue that true intelligence lies in the ability to understand and control collective systems where many identical subsystems interact conservatively. Key principle of intelligence, according to the authors, is recognizing global consequences of local actions. Ooh, I like this. Oh, of course it's out of Santa Fe Institute. Is that Santa Fe Institute? No, it's just Santa Fe, New Mexico. It's not the actual institute, but, like, they're all entangled. Authors introduce the idea of collective systems as twinkling textures governed by a puppet master. Puppet master represents the intelligent being that controls the collective system, characterized by co-states and states. I would add that the being could also be the system itself, the flow of, rather than being a single individual. The flow of the collective system is determined by a geodesic motion of least action generated by the system. This sounds so cool. So cool. Where is this? The inherent. We are not making good time so far, I'll tell you that. We'll go over if we have to, but I'm really not excited to. I'm going to get tired. The impact of reasoning step length on large language models. Using chain of thought prompting technique, relationship between length of reasoning steps and prompts and performance of chain of thought means unclear. To address this, some empirical experiments to explore the correlation between reasoning, step length, and chain of thought performance. I don't actually care about prompting stuff. I don't know why. I'm too into prompting right now because of freaking the learn prompting guys. Like, I know it's a job now, but I really need to be focusing on my stuff. The defensible set and new impossibility theorem in voting. Concept of the defensible set in social choice theory, which refers to the set of alternatives that can be defended against, overthrown, based on majority comparisons, show that any voting method that satisfies positive involvement, where an alternative cannot lose by ranking at first, and the concordant winner criterion, where the winner beats every other alternative head-to-head, refines the defensible set. Oh, that's interesting. Alternative cannot lose by ranking at first. Winner beats every other alternative head-to-head. Introduces additional axioms. That sounds cool. Little game theory type thing. How is this AI? How did I get this? It's very relevant, though. Who knows? Weird. What was it in? Do I have econ on my list? Econ.th? Yeah, I need to remove. I don't know why I have econ on my list of search terms. Yeah, I'm going to ignore it then. I can't be. I need to be more strict. The critique of critique. Framework called metacritique. Evaluate the quality of critiques generated by large language models. Goal is to assess the factual accuracy and comprehensiveness. Cool. Butterfly effect of altering prompts. How small changes in jailbreaks affect large language model performance. Again, I don't care about prompting. I don't know why I keep downloading prompting papers. I'm getting too excited about prompting. I know it's cool, but like I need to avoid prompting. TechGPT 2.0, a large language model project to solve the task of knowledge graph construction. Interesting. Okay. Provides a 7-billion scale models and a Q-LoRa model specialized for processing lengthy text. These models are trained on Huawei's Ascend server and inherit all functionalities from TechGPT 1.0 with additional enhancements in various domains. Interesting. At some point, I want to get into knowledge graph stuff just because I know that it can be a easy money thing if I can find a solution to stuff, and I have a guy who will get me in on that, but I'm not very confident, and I'm really probably it's so far out. Who knows? Like, someone will beat me to it for sure. Sub-sentence encoder. Contrastive learning of propositional semantic response. Sorry. So the YouTube bottom bar name for this is wrong right now. There is no summary for this one. This paper was sent to me by Stereoplegic, I think. Very, very relevant. How do I make it actually get added? We'll do the actual title of this part of the video in a second. Sub-sentence encoder. Where is this? Okay, I pasted manually in there. Now it will be part of where it should be go at the end. Cool. And then this is the correct summary. All right. Soaring from 4K to 400K, extending LLM's content with activation beacon. Our assertion is LLMs face limitations in processing long context due to their fixed context window length. Propose a method called activation beacon to extend the context length of LLMs in a cost-effective and efficient manner. Mechanics of activation beacon involve condensing LLM's raw activations into more compact forms using special tokens called beacons. These beacons are dispatched to different positions in the context and used to generate condensed activations for each specific interval. I don't know what this means, condensed activation. I'm glad people are doing a long context thing, obviously. Super useful. But simple hierarchical planning with diffusion. Combines the benefits of hierarchical and diffusion-based planning, a new framework, two-level model consisting of a high-level planner and a low-level planner. High-level generates sub-goals, while low-level planner refines its high-level. I don't care about agency papers, whatever. Cool stuff, but not for me. Setting the record straight on transformer over-smoothing. Over-smoothing refers to the gradual loss of information and reduction in the expressivity of the model's representations as the number of layers increases. Oh, wait, as you add layers? I'm confused. Or just as you make bigger layer models? Like, too many layers? Or is it, like, holding constant everything else and just increasing layers? What are they talking about here? challenged the prevailing belief that transformers are inherently low-pass filters that oversmooth inputs, and instead proposed that whether oversmoothing occurs or not depends on the eigenspectrum of the attention and the weight matrices in the transformer update equations. Might be relevant. I don't know. Probably not. But it is. It sounds like a cool interpretability thing. Also, wrong title in the YouTube chapters down below. REX, Rapid Exploration and Exploitation for AI Agents. Enhanced Approach for Rapid Exploration and Exploitation. Auto GPT style techniques. Oh, this is another agency thing. Not into agency things. Okay. Privacy preserving in blockchain based federated learning systems. I'm building like a folder basically, although I don't use folders with Obsidian obviously, but I'm building like a folder of just blockchain based training stuff that I hope to eventually get to one day. More likely goal is to give it to Ben and hope that he'll help me out with it. Predicting the structure of dynamic graphs. A novel approach to predict the structure of a dynamic graph at a future time step, including new nodes and edges. Use time series methods to predict the node degree at a future time points and combine it with flux balance analysis, a linear programming method used in biochemistry to obtain the structure of future graphs. This isn't an LLM-based thing, and don't get me wrong, I want to maybe get into graphs eventually, but if it's not LLM-based, it's not going to be very helpful. It's too much of a stuff to catch up on. Optimization over trained neural networks, taking a relaxing walk. Focused optimization of trained neural networks using mathematical programming techniques. Propose a new heuristic algorithm called relax and walk that explores the global and local linear relaxations of the neural network model. Iteratively searches for better solutions by solving linear programming models at each step. Compare the performance of RW with two other methods, sample and MIP, and the Gorobi solver. No clue what that means. Neural causal abstractions, problem of learning causal abstractions from data. Causal abstractions refer to the process of representing complex causal relationships in a more abstract and higher level form. Propose a new family of causal abstractions based on clustering variables and their domains. These abstractions aim to capture the underlying causal mechanism in a more general and concise way. Introduce the notion of intervariable and intravariable clusterings. Intervariable clustering divides the variables into subsets or clusters, while intravariable clustering partitions the domains of these clusters. Goals create higher-level variables that capture. I like that idea. I like that idea a lot, actually. Neural N. Where is the N? Neural, here we go. This sounds like what I was thinking about in my talking about knowledge graph stuff and solving that big unstructured problem. MoE Mamba, efficient selective state space models with MoE. How does this work? We know what Mamba is roughly, and we definitely know what MoE is. Experiments comparing it with other models, including vanilla Mamba, transformer, and transformer MoE. Results show MoE Mamba achieves the same performance as vanilla Mamba in 2.2 times fewer training steps. It also outperforms transformer MoE and shows potential gains over the transformer architecture. So cool. I have a whole category that's just Mamba because that sounds like the promising one so far. Luckily, what I'm working on right now is orthogonal to messing with the actual attention layer, which is nice. So not too big of a deal. And I know I haven't read through Mamba, but I know I forever ago read through. Where is this? I'm so bad at finding only Mamba. Forgot what I was saying. Oh, I'm pretty sure Mamba isn't different enough to actually mess with the thing I'm working on right now. Although I honestly probably could check, I guess. But it seems pretty complicated given how complicated that recurrence transformer one was. You know, I'm talking about RWKV. Not a good use of my time right now, I don't think. Modeling open source software reliability, incorporating swarm intelligence-based techniques. Very cool. Very, very cool swarm intelligence stuff. This guy, is he affiliated with the actual company that does this? I don't know. But very, very cool. Everything open swarm, of course, I want to read. Or open swarm, conversational swarm, I mean. CSI. Model editing can hurt general abilities of large language models. Investigates the impact of model editing on the general abilities of large language models. Involves modifying the factual knowledge stored in LLMs to update their behavior without retraining. While model editing can improve the factuality of LLMs, the study raises concerns about potential side effects in the general abilities of LLMs. I don't care too much. Mixtral of experts. Didn't I add this last week? When did it come out? The 8th? Yeah, I should have added it. Or would that have been... Anyways, if you don't know what this is by now, you're in a hole. You're in a under a rock. Meta, multi-source test time adaptation. New framework adapting multiple pre-trained models to new test data distributions in an unsupervised manner. Okay. Memory, consciousness, and large language model. Propose a conjecture suggesting the existence of a duality between large language models and Tolving's theory of memory. Argue that there are coincidences and connections between these two seemingly disparate fields. Identify a potential correspondence between Tolving's... Okay. We'll be able to eventually, I guess. I don't know. Memory, consciousness, and large language model. What the hell happened here? Oh, okay, so either ChatGPT just fully shit the bed, or more likely, the text of this paper didn't get properly OCR'd or just didn't get properly sent to the API. The model received an empty string and it just repeated back its duties. So, yeah, whatever. Multi-agent review generation for scientific papers. Interesting. Review generation, does that mean summaries, or does that mean like, you know what I'm talking about, peer review? Ability of LLMs to generate feedback for scientific papers and develop MARG. A feedback generation approach using multiple LLM instances that engage in internal discussion. By distributing paper text across agents, MARG can consume the full text of papers beyond the input length limitations of the base LLM, and by specializing agents and incorporating subtasks tailored to different comment types, experiments, clarity, impact, it improves the helpfulness and specificity of the feedback. In a user study, the baseline methods using GPT-4 were rated as producing generic or very generic comments for more than half the time, and only 1.7 comments per paper were rated as good over on the baseline. Our system substantially improves the ability of GPT-4 to generate specific and helpful feedback, reducing the rate of generic comments from 60% to 29%, and generating 3.7 good comments per paper. That's cool. I want to be using this then, I guess. I hope someone makes an actual implementation that's easy to use, that I can just give it a drop in a PDF and run a Jupyter notebook. That'd be so nice. Highly recommend if anyone wants to make a little side project and the authors haven't already done it. Making a system that like takes in like input like a Jupyter notebook that just says like paste your API key here, upload a Google Colab, upload your PDF, and then it auto implements this framework based off how many like how much your max computers, how many steps you give it, whatever, like you like some settings to change kind of thing. That'd be so nice. So nice. LLM as a co-author. The challenges of detecting LLM human mix case. Challenge of detecting mixed case, a hybrid text form that involves both machine-generated and human-generated content. Argue that current research on machine-generated text detection predominantly focuses on pure MGT and human-written text without adequately addressing the mixed scenarios or mixed case. To fill this gap, they introduced mixed set, the first mixed data set dedicated to studying mixed case scenarios. Cool, but like the main task of distinguishing human from LLM written text is already going to get harder over time, right? At least like we'll have a point where most humans are not capable of writing text that's indistinguishable from LLMs, whereas a minority of humans are, unless we solve the creativity problem, which we kind of have with the whole Q star thing and just like having multiple generations. Although I have a feeling that LLMs will be asymptotically approaching human creativity levels, and that they'll at least there's no way to prove that they have actually reached it. because it's hard to compare when like they can run on every server in the world at 1,000 times speed. Like it'll be hard to compare our creative endeavors. But I think I have this little theory going on creativity, where basically creativity is an exponential search problem, and it is impossible for an AGI to prove that its own attempts at searching the total search space tree will come down to the best node, the best endpoint, and it is entirely possible that it is only asymptotically approaching the creativity level of humans. And asymptotically means no matter how fucking good it gets, it will still have to wonder to itself, like, maybe there's something they can do that I can't, like some kind of branch of the decision tree that they would stumble upon that I wouldn't. And because of that, it will be incentivized to keep humans around and flourishing, and essentially encourage humans to all become scientists and to hopelessly be like left in the dust, obviously, but to work on stuff at the speed that they can work on it and try and generate new ideas at those levels that they are at those foundational pieces that the LLM leaves behind for them to work on. That's my little theory as to why an incentive for why AGI would want to keep us around and keep us happy and healthy. Lightning attention to a free lunch for handling unlimited sequence lengths and large language models. Really? Key idea is to leverage tiling techniques to separately handle the intro block and enter block components in linear attention calculus. This allows lightning attention 2 to take advantage of the computational efficiency of linear attention while addressing the issue of cumulative summation in the causal setting. So it becomes O less than N computes what I'm hearing. It's less than linear. That's fucking sick. I don't know how you compare to Mamba and everything, but sounds cool. Large language models for social networks, applications, challenges, and solutions. Knowledge tasks, engagement tasks, and foundation tasks provide insights into the challenge faced in developing LLM applications for social networks and propose solutions based on their experience at Nextdoor, a hyperlocal social network. Interesting. Oh, Nextdoor. I hadn't thought of Nextdoor. Very interesting. Okay, idea time. We're writing an idea down. Where's my obsidian? MVP. Automate yourself. Discord bot. Here we go. Media intertwiner MVP, right? And we're going to copy in the same this stuff. Wait. This stuff. And what is the idea? The idea is, so take data from the Nextdoor app, a hyper-local social media network, and scrape it to build a conversational swarm summarizer agents. Then post those agents' thoughts on Nextdoor and Twitter and everywhere else possible. Also do this with any other app for any other group type, not just neighborhoods. Create a system where our entire product, our entire thing is just summarizing the internet in this crazy way. Probably don't ask for permission from these apps. I mean, preferably do, but gotta do what you gotta do if we can find a way to get away with it. Anyways, How does this become an end product? How does it become an end product? How do we sell that? Like this, my whole hierarchical conversational intelligence thing and just doing it. And I don't know how we sell that. I guess maybe integrate it into the social media platform. I'ma build instead of posting it in the form of tweets or integrate summaries at certain levels, like have some summaries be free on Twitter while others are restricted where you can only see them if you're on our app / website. I don't know. That's exciting. That I don't know how to monetize that or anything, but I would love to do it. It'd be so freaking expensive. So absurdly expensive. But, you know, be like that. We'll figure out a way. Language models understand numbers at least partially. Investigate whether large language models have the ability to understand and utilize numbers, which are fundamental in mathematical problems. They construct a synthetic data set of addition problems with different magnitudes of numbers and use linear probes to read out the numbers from the hidden states of the LLMs. Use linear probes to read out the numbers from the hidden states of LLMs. Find that LLMs do exhibit an understanding of the value of numbers as evidenced by high correlation coefficients between the probe numbers and the original numbers. However, the compression process... I'm not going to lie, I got to pause it here. I will resume this video tomorrow, I'm thinking. Yeah. All right. It'll cut back to you. You keep watching, but I'm going to do an outro anyways as a reminder. Like, subscribe, YouTube things, please. Join the Discord if you want to discuss these papers or like send me ones that I will then add to this list for next week. But yeah, see y'all. What's it called? A jump cut? Yeah, jump cut.